Hi, I'd like to provide you with an introduction to a free cash flow model for valuing stocks. This model is included in a spreadsheet that downloads data from Capital IQ if you have the Excel plugin installed. So let me go over some of the points I'd like to cover. First, if you're interested in understanding the assumptions and companies that this is best suited for, I encourage you to go to page 366 of the Investment Valuation textbook by Aswath Damodaran. And in this, he describes this three-stage cash flow model, which this spreadsheet is based on. I'd like to review a couple of things associated with the spreadsheet, but it's probably useful just to actually pull up the spreadsheet and show you sort of the details associated with it. So, I've got the Capital IQ plugin installed in Excel, and you can see that up here as one of the tabs that creates a pull-down menu. And I'm going to click on the spreadsheet, and it's going to load it in. And I know this is pretty small for you to look at, so what I'm going to do is increase the size of this. One of the things that is important to know is that you've got to have this Capital IQ plugin installed. And not only do you have to have it installed, but you have to have your ID and password in the settings. So if you take a look at your settings, you can see it's got my user ID right here. It's also got my password. So it will automatically log in when needed to download data from the Capital IQ website. It starts off with having Starbucks here. Cell B2 is very important because you want to put the ticker symbol in for the company that you're trying to value. In fact, while we're on the subject, it's important to note that all the cells that you can alter are shown in yellow. So these are user inputs. It's got some defaults, meaning it will download some data into it and put a sample number in there, but that doesn't mean it's the right number. It's up to you to figure out what is the right number for the particular company that you're trying to analyze. So let's enter in a ticker symbol into cell B2. I'm going to put in Microsoft, and you can see that it goes out and downloads the data associated with Microsoft. And Microsoft is, of course, a company in the information technology period. It shows that the latest period was March 31st. And that's basically for the last 12 months. That's the date that it's using. Is this the right risk-free rate? Well, it actually downloads this from Capital IQ, but you may not want to use the 10-year treasury bill rate for the risk-free rate. Notice that for the risk premium, it's just got 6%. This is definitely something where you would want to go to Damodaran's website and download the latest equity risk premium. It's downloading the 5-year beta from Capital IQ, and it's assuming that this is ultimately going to go to 1. It's downloading the analyst forecast for earnings over the next 5 years. These tend to be overly optimistic, so you might want to reduce that. It assumes that the revenue growth and the earnings growth are going to be the same. This is a three-stage model. So stage one is going to be the high growth period, and it's going to make assumptions about capital expenditures, depreciation, and working capital. Stage two is going to be a transition period towards a stable growth period. And the stable growth period is actually shown right here in stage three. Ultimately, what this is going to do is give you a number in cell F18, and that's your intrinsic value. According to this model, this is the target price or true valuation of this company. $57.26 is the worth of one share of Microsoft stock. You compare that to the current price, which is right now $41.99. This model is clearly saying this company is a buy. It's undervalued based off of these revenue projections. Of course, achieving revenue growth of 8.5% and earnings growth of 8.5% over the next 5 years is going to be incredibly challenging. This is actually making pro forma free cash flow projections. And let me show you how to do this, because Some of these cells are actually frozen, and the thing that you need to do is go to view and unfreeze the panes if you'd like to scroll over and see some of the additional proformas here. You can see that it's got the latest numbers for the fiscal year, and it shows that Microsoft had free cash flow of $22 billion. It's making a projection for free cash flow for the fiscal year ending in March 2015, and it's assuming that the free cash flow is going to be $23.44 billion at that time. And you can see that it's making projections all the way out to the fiscal year that ends in the last day of March 2029. How is it doing this? Well, you've got a length of stage 1 of 5 years, a length of the transition of 10, and that means that the stage 3 starts in 15 years. Note this tab down here at the bottom, which has historical data in it. Here you can see data for lots of periods. In fact, it's going to go back 15 years. As you can see, it's got data for the fiscal year minus 15, which is 15 years ago. And it produces a number of charts. So this is just a quick overview. This is a spreadsheet that you're going to want to have to play around with. And I've got another video associated with the assumptions of the model and the weaknesses that you're going to want to take a look at as well. This is a great tool for quickly applying a model, the three-stage model, to a particular company. So this is a great tool, but it doesn't mean it's the right tool for analyzing the company. That's a decision you're going to have to make based on your analysis of the company.